Good evening. Thank you. Gracias. Gracias. Buenas noches. Tengo que mirar a ver quién está. Bueno, antes que nada, I cannot tell you how humbled I am to be here with you this evening receiving this recognition. There is something that my wife tells me and reminds me of every day. She says, it's by giving that you receive. It's by giving that you receive blessings. It's by giving that you receive love. And I brought my wife on stage accompanied by our family, at least part of our family, our two sons, their respective wives, and their daughters. Our other two daughters are not here. Our niece, the niece is sitting in one of the tables over there. But I wanted my family to share this moment. And so I'd like you to give them a big round of applause because this is what makes it possible. La hermana chiquita se está ahí con mi niece, Gigi, Juliana, who's 3 years old. Right, I'm not going to say to you. She's a blind person and a community. First, Lucia Mayerson-David. If I speak about Lucia Mayerson-David, I have to speak about Jaime Rodriguez, the comandante, because the history, aplauso para el comandante, because the history of this community always has been those who step up to the plate to acknowledge our presence, but at the same time celebrate who we are. And in the words of our dear friend David Morales, empower this community. And it was through Jaime that 28 years ago was the birth of what we're celebrating tonight at Jolgorio. He's in Isabela, Puerto Rico. Den un aplauso que se oiga en Puerto Rico a Jaime Rodriguez. Pero Lucia Mayerson-David was the one that embraced El Jolgorio so that the program could assist the talented and gifted students, of which my son is an alum, José Pablo. It would embrace the idea of Hispanic Writers Week, and it would be a way for us, as in the words of Kadish, promoting young people so that they can succeed and lead lives where they will contribute and pay it back, because it's by giving that you receive. Lucia Mayerson-David would call me every Saturday night on my radio show, sin falta. La primera llamada telefónica que llegaba a la emisora. Joseito, Lucia, estoy escuchando. Every Saturday night. Back in 1996-97, I did a concert tour with Mark Anthony and Ruben Blaze. And it was sponsored by Major League Baseball players. And the first show we'll see in Boston at the Heinz Auditorium, Will Condero, who played for the Red Sox, was a sponsor. And part of the sponsorship meant that he would buy tickets for high school students. I called Lucia and I asked her, Lucia, I've got 200 tickets. What can you do with them? She said, don't worry about it. Who here was at that concert as a tag student? Stand up if you were there. Stand up, those of you who were there as tag students, because Lucia made it possible for these high school students to be there and see Mark Anthony perform before he was the Mark Anthony that we know today. And when you read the reviews, the students and the teenagers who were screaming from the balcony for Mark Anthony were these young people who today are the leaders of our community. That's the legacy of Lucia Mayerson-David.